much for being here. We just wanted to bring the full gang out for today just to get it started before we start to break into our little group. So we're very lucky this year to have Fox. So we're actually normally four in the section, and we're lucky to have an Academy Fellow this year to join us for this program and for our Hong Kong Phil season. And we have Adams, our contrabassoonist, Toby, and Vance. And so today, this afternoon, is a little bit of a, let's call it a bassoon sort of taster session. You'll see some solo bassoon duos, a couple quartets with contrabassoon, and we'll finish with some more popular sort of known tunes of Debussy and Mussorgsky at the end. With we'll bring all five of us back out. So I hope you enjoy it, and yeah, I think we'll get started.
Thank you. Thank you. Father of the bassoons is obviously my contrabassoon, very love to play. And we thought it might be nice just to show where the contrabassoon started its journey in orchestra, which was with in a proper symphony, which is Beethoven's Fifth Symphony, and he uses it in the last movement, and it comes in at the beginning of the last movement, and he writes very interestingly for contra. He uses it sort of doubling cello, bass, sometimes a bassoon. It's kind of its own thing. So it's quite interesting. So we thought we'd do a couple of little just excerpts from the last movement of Beethoven's Fifth, just to show it what you might hear if you came to the orchestra and heard the contrabassoon, how you would hear the contrabassoon in the orchestra. So there's a little short couple of bars that I'm going to play just by myself, and then we'll play as a group, and then we're going to play the same sort of 8 bars, but start a bit earlier and finish a bit later. And then it includes sort of going back to the beginning of this first movement. It's a sort of repeat, so you'll hear when the contrabassoon comes in on this sort of big C major moment at the start of the fourth movement of the fifth symphony. So he uses a lot of these little arpeggio figures. Longer passage. We're going to start a bit earlier and then go back, and then the chord we just finished on is the when it goes back to the beginning of this fourth movement. Short little concert solo that we used to play, written nearly 100 years ago, Erwin Schulhoff. And the three movements are quite sort of self-descriptive, really. The first one, just melancholia, so it describes the mood. It starts low and then climbs up and then gradually sort of falls back down. And then the second movement is this just long stream of repeated fast notes, just trying to keep going, motto perpetual movement. And then the last movement is this little fugue, but obviously it can't really play a fugue with one instrument, so it's just like an idea of a fugue, kind of lows contrasting with highs, louds and softs and stuff.
Thank you. Thank you. Oh.